Let's be clear. I do not condone anything that Mr. Johnson said in a hateful manner or that advocates violence against any of my fellow counselors. I want to make it perfectly clear that I reject and disassociate myself from any such rhetoric. It's telling, however, that while I stand against these extreme views, the mayor and Pickering City Council seem to have no problem with similar attacks when they're directed at me. Their selective outrage and double standards only reveal their hypocrisy. They can't have it both ways. Criticizing Mr. Johnson's comments while tactically endorsing or ignoring the hateful attacks against me. Councillor Brenner has said violent, hateful things to me, such as he could stick a knife in my back slowly twist it, and that I wouldn't know it was there until he was getting ready to pull it out. There is also a video circulating where Brenner has also been caught on tape in a remark towards the mayor saying that he would like to sharpen his sword and decapitate the and excuse my language. But the mayor and council have heard this recording. And I have told them of the sexual, psychological, and workplace violence that I have gone through, and all I get is crickets. Why? Because I refuse to play their game of deceit and corruption, and instead, I speak the truth. Here's the real issue. This council is squirming because they're getting a taste of their own medicine. They've been busy labeling anyone who dares to question their agenda as extremists, racists, Nazis, or even worse. Now, when somebody else throws similar accusations their way, they cry foul. It's the height of hypocrisy. The council's attempts to deflect Mr. Johnson's actions on me is laughable, especially considering their own history of name-calling and vicious attacks on anyone who opposes their narrative. A council member wants to stab me in the back and decapitate the mayor, and nothing. Mayor Ash and the council members are outraged that their personal information was published, which I had nothing to do with, but it can easily be found on social media. But let's not forget their own role in all of this mess. They've been more than happy to throw around harsh labels like pedophiles, racists, nutcases, conspiracy theories, Nazis, transphobic, homophobic, alt-right, and fascist against their critics. And now they're acting all high and mighty because the same treatment is being directed at them. Spare us the theatrics. If they want to dish out insults and divisive rhetoric to the people of Pickering and Durham, then they shouldn't be surprised when it comes back to bite them. This is what I call karma. Furthermore, let's address their whining about being mocked for their appearance. It's a classic case of don't dish it out if you can't take it. This council has a history of indulging in petty personal attacks against anyone who disagrees with them, including on social media. Now that the tables are turned, they want to play the victim. Their complaints about mocking are nothing more than a smokescreen to distract from their own egregious behavior. And let's not ignore the broader issue. The council is desperately trying to suppress any kind of dissent or criticism that challenges their agenda. They're trying to paint anyone who opposes their policies as right-wing extremists or hate groups, all while pushing their own divisive and authoritarian policies. It's a blatant attempt to silence opposition and to stifle genuine debate. They have participated in numerous draconian bylaws over the past few months or so to stop public engagement and participation in council meetings of those who have opposing or dissenting views. The mayor and council's outcry is nothing more than a desperate, hypocritical attempt to cling to power and protect their increasingly indefensible actions. Their efforts to discredit anyone who speaks out against them only further reveals their true colors. It's time to call out this charade for what it is. and recognize their hypocrisy for what it truly is: a calculated effort to maintain control by any means necessary. My time on council, I have been fighting against their attempts to segregate people into groups by the color of their skin, their religious beliefs, or their sexual preferences. I've been fighting Pickering Council to remain neutral and not place special interest groups above others. And I've been fighting for every man, woman, boy, and girl to have the right to choose between using a biological bathroom of their choice or choosing a universal change room inclusive of all genders and or families. And that age restrictions should be placed on pride events and drag queen story time. But because of my views, along with the majority of residents in Pickering and beyond who support these views, I am being targeted by my own council and the corporation of the City of Pickering to silence me by any means necessary. For over the last year, I have been unrelenting in exposing the corruption, the coercion, and the perceived bribery happening within the corporation of the City of Pickering. My fellow councillors are terrified of the truth coming to light that they are desperately trying to silence my dissenting voice by any means necessary. And they will stop at nothing to maintain their grip on power and keep their unethical practices hidden from you, the public. Furthermore, my fellow councillors have been actively working to change the Municipal Act to revoke the position of an elected member of council. This move is profoundly undemocratic. We are elected by you, the people, and having opposing views does not give them the right to undermine democracy and remove representatives as they see fit. If they don't believe in democracy, then they are unfit to hold the positions that they are in. This blatant power grab is an attempt to silence dissent and control the narrative, bypassing the very principles of democracy that our country is built upon. I'm Councillor Lisa Robinson. I was elected to represent and serve the public, and as such, my loyalty is not to bend a knee to lobbyist groups or to be beholden to any of my colleagues. Thank you, and God bless.